After learning a lot of interesting things about high calorific values and process, and staring at this machine at the same time, I now like to give you some information about this blue machine. My presentation starts with some technical details. How does the system work? Some numbers, some costs, applications, upgrades, and a general overview about the BACKHUS Turner range. So this is really the world's first BACKHUS CON series machine. It adds the dynamic turning aspect to the conventional membrane system, drying system, and because we have these walls, we get around 25% more capacity at the same footprint, so it's a very space efficient system too. Some technical details. So what you see here with this white cover is the cover winder. Then we have the drum. You see the drum here. We have a special tool arrangement on the drum. It's different to the windrow turner systems because we don't pick up a triangular windrow. We pick up more a tabular, more block system, and want to create another block behind the machine again. We have cameras which help the operator to find, to detect, and to find the walls. And also ultrasound sensors, which after the walls are, found or the machine is positioned, which guide the machine through the walls or via the walls. We have three different sizes available, so it varies between 6 and 10 meters. We have those walls. They are 1.2 meters high, 25 centimeters wide, and three different machines. The machine you see here is the CON 60. 60 means the difference between the walls. The inside the distance is 6 meters. We also have a 70.5 meters, and the big one is the CON 100. We have 10 meter wide windrows. So how does it work? We basically have three working steps in one. What we do is We take the cover, that's step one. After that we turn the material, and after the material is turned, you rarely can see it, we have another cover behind the machine. We put another cover, or a new cover on the lane again. So the benefit of this system compared to conventional turning systems is that we only have a very small portion really open to the atmosphere. Most of the windrow is still covered in the front and newly covered in the back. If you compare it with, say, you turn with a loader, what you do, you take all the cover, 50 meters long. So 50 meters of material is exposed to the atmosphere for the time the loader really needs to turn. And the capacity of a loader is five times less, is 20% of the capacity of our turner here. So to give you an example, when you have, say, 1,000 cubic meters in your lane, this will take 1 hour with this machine, or it will take 5 hours with a loader. So to find the walls, the operator needs the cameras. We have two cameras, one on the right, one on the left side. You see it here on the presentation and also on the machine. While after the walls are found, we have these ultrasound sensors, two in the front and two in the back, left and right. And as I said before, it's in the lanes, it's a fully autonomous system. We call it coming from semi-automatic to the fully autonomous operation mode in the lane, where we take the cover. We can, if necessary, you can even irrigate, where you don't talk about a drying system but a composting system. We also can irrigate the material. So that's the drum, where the magic happens, if you like, where that's the dynamic part of this system. We turn the material, it's a horizontal position drum, as you can see. Because of the tool arrangement, we mix the material. We have a shredding effect also, a little grinding effect, and it homogenizes the material, it's blending, blends the material, breaks down air channels, so the whole windrow has to find new air channels, avoids anaerobic pockets. It also avoids dry areas in the system, because we break everything totally down and it has to restart again. And yes, some economics. If we compare our system, we always compare our system with systems where you have loaders. And I don't have a real specific example here. It's just some general figures. But what you can say is, because of the capacity of the turner compared to the windrow turner, we can turn the material more often during the process time. Because we can turn it more often, we optimize the process conditions. And by optimizing the process conditions, we reduce the process time. So we compare here 20 days with our machine, with the CON 60, to 23 days with the wheel loader. The capacity per hour is 1,000 cubic meters per hour. With the wheel loader, you may do 200, 250 cubic meters per hour. So only 20%. Fuel consumption, of course, with the loader is less. It's 46% only, but because you do much more working hours per year, 250% more working hours, although you turn less times, you also have more fuel consumption. So the fuel costs are higher on that machine. Labor costs are higher because you have much more working hours. Fuel costs, I mentioned that already. Operating costs also higher. To give you an idea, when we do 1,000 hours a year with our machine, we probably do 2,500 hours with a wheel loader. So 1,000 hours with our machine means 2 maintenance intervals. 2,500 hours is 5 maintenance intervals. So we also have more cost there. Of course, the machine is more expensive, but generally speaking, all in all, it's a more economic system. Typical applications, you heard about that during the presentations before. It's a municipal solid waste. It's not just biological drying, it's also composting. Yes, upgrading, we call it upgrading your operation. There are compost sites out there where you have just an open windrow system. You can, of course, also add the membrane to it. And by adding the membrane to it, you have a controlled, closed process environment, which you are independent from weather condition. It optimizes your process, speeds up the process, and reduces emissions in many ways. A little bit about company. It's was founded in 85. We are members to the Eggersmann Group since 2012. It's a long way coming from really small windrow turners to this system. We have around 1,300 machines running in the world over 30 years in more than 75 countries, and they process around 20 million tons of waste. And yeah, that's the end of my presentation. Thank you.